For a small village, Carrigallen really punches above its weight when it comes to amateur drama. They've been putting on dramas here since the 1800s, and this year the local drama group The Cornmill are hoping to win the All-Ireland with their new irreverent play, The Devil's Ceili.
The Devil's Ceili, okay, well it's a play written by two Cavan men. It's set in Cavan, it's set in 1960s dance hall, Ceili Hall. It's a usual tale that's been told all around the country, but when the devil appeared in a local parish. And we get the story through three characters. A stranger comes among the parish, comes among the community, and meets these three men and supplies them with LSD unknowingly to them. And they have a little experience on the drug, and all sorts of wonderful capers come out of that.
So an old story with a contemporary twist. Also in the play, the local priest falls in love with the village sweetheart.
Well, hello, ladies.
Hello, Father.
Joining your hands in prayer, I see, Miss Riley.
I am, Father.
And you a new hairdo?
I do, Father.
For anyone special?
Just for myself, Father.
He is. He's a lecherous, power-hungry womanizer, yeah. He's, it's a bit of a stereotypical, maybe, male chauvinist 1960s priest who gets his comeuppance in the end, you know.
I see young Ignatius is here from England again.
He is, Father.
I believe he gave you a lift home the last time he was back.
He did, Father.
I saw his car parked in a gap up the Bullaroe Hill.
Did you, Father?
Yes, I did.
He's actually in love with her. And he really loves her, and he's the frustration of being celibate and being a priest, that he's in love with this girl. He's trying to help her, she's a widow, so he's doing his best, he's helping her, but he's fallen in love with her, basically.
See you, Father.
It is a big commitment, but then again, you know, it's our thing, that's what we're into, you know, it's our hobby, it's our pastime, it's what we spend our time doing. But I mean, if you want to do it and do it right, which Carrigallen always do, which is why they're a successful group, then you have to put in the time and the effort.
Yeah, you know, it does take up so much of your time, as my darling wife, who calls herself a bit of a drama widow, that's why I got her involved, you know, so that at least she can be part of it, and it doesn't, I don't feel as bad, you know, when I come home, because it takes up so much of your time. You're thinking about it, yeah, 24-7, you're reading the script, you're thinking about ideas, you're thinking of how you can improve it.
Sex was such a powerful thing back then, we barely mentioned it. It was so powerful, it was almost poisonous. Oh, it's a danger out there, I tell you.
The cast and crew is made up of people from the local community who balance their day jobs with constant rehearsals in the lead up to Athlone.
This is Stephen who's in the play coming up, so he might stop and wave him down. I mean, everybody in this community comes from different backgrounds, different walks of life, and we have one person here like Stephen who's making lots of noise.
One of the newest members of the group is 22-year-old Danny Smith. And this is her very first time involved in a drama.
I'm from Carrigallen here, and I was asked around October if I'd be interested in taking part in a play, and I've always wanted to take part in Cormac production because we grew up watching it, and so I said yes, naturally.
Danny was cast as the local sweetheart, Mairead Mulligan, but after 6 months of rehearsing, she has to bow out.
Unfortunately, I'm not going to be taking part in Athlone because I actually got a job with Emirates in Dubai and I'm flying out the week of the All-Ireland. I'm actually a physio by trade, and unfortunately there wasn't enough work around here for me, so I decided I'd go see the world and I applied for a job as an air hostess with Emirates. I was really upset to be missing All-Ireland. I've been rehearsing for 6 months and Mairead Mulligan's become part of my life, to be honest, and to be missing out on that All-Ireland, I was pretty devastated to find out at first. And like, it's our day in Coker, really. You build up for 6 months for this moment, and to miss out on the final hurdle, it's pretty upset. So.
Stepping in at the last minute to play the part is Danny's friend Elizabeth.
I know the play real well, and I've been in the play as a smaller character, and Ronan asked me if I wouldn't mind taking over Mairead Mulligan. And obviously it was a bit bittersweet at first, because we don't want to lose Danielle, and she's been here for 6 months rehearsing, but it's going to be good.
The group have been called for a meeting in the Cornmill Theatre, where director Ronan lays down some harsh realities.
If you go through what the adjudicators have said at every festival, there seems to be one thing in the marking that's coming out that we need to look at, and that's acting, you know, and including myself in that.
there's a couple of different opinions. Obviously, with such a huge cast, there's obviously so many different opinions, and people are throwing their opinions out there.
But a few things have to be tightened up on. I mean, if we take in Phil and the girls scene, and we'll look at that and work on it, because I think every element of the scene, of each scene, can be worked on, be it the posturing.
The Ronan Ward, the director, now he would drive you bonker. No, Ronan's okay. Ah, yeah, no, I mean, you do have fallings out as well, you know, but difference of opinion, shall we call it.
We all know the flashy bits work, but it's only 20%. The 80% is the actual play itself, and that's the bit we have to improve on.
Yeah, there's always a bit of banter, there's always a bit of slagging that goes on, there's always something happens there.
Ronan, can we do an extra few rehearsals to make sure your lines are right?
Karina, yeah. There's lots of comedians in this group, isn't there? Well, the funny thing about it is with lines, if you're often given the right cue, you'll give the right line, you see?
After rehearsals that went late into the evening, Sean McIntyre opens his florist early the next morning. Sean has been involved in local drama for over 30 years, and this year plays one of the lead roles.
I've done a setting and a bit of lighting and even dabbled in directing a couple of times. I prefer to be on the stage myself now, yeah.
Why is that?
Well, less pressure.
Hello, Mrs. Mulligan, how are you?
I'm good, Mickey.
So, Mrs. Mulligan, it's a great night.
It is.
Good music.
It is, Mickey.
It's, you know, it passes the long winter nights. But, you know, you're in a little world of your own, I think, up there, you know. You forget even that there's an audience looking in at you at times, you know.
And after 30 years on stage, is he ever tempted to give it up?
I think I'd hate to see a show going on that I wasn't involved in, you know. You wouldn't have the same interest in it. I think I'd find myself sneaking up to watch rehearsals or something anyway, you know.
With only days to go, the pressure is on to make this the best performance to ever come out of Carrigallen.
There's one player you're going to remember, it's our play.
Yes, definitely. Everyone, whether we win or whether we don't, Athlone will be talking about our play.
Look, at Athlone, the key to Athlone is getting there. We didn't make it last year, we're there this year. We're there with a new director, a brand new, really unheard of piece by two unknown writers. We're there with half a crew that have never been on stage before in the circuit.
And do they dream of winning?
We think of winning, yes, but you know the element of getting to Athlone is the key thing. You know, you want to get there first of all, and everybody's a winner. Every one of those nine nights, every one of those nine groups could win. It's down to one man's opinion. Yeah, of course we think of winning, but look, we'll see how it goes.